The former manager of Rose McGowan has been found dead in an apparent suicide, her family has confirmed. Jill Messick represented McGowan in 1997, when the actress claims she was raped by movie mogul Harvey Weinstein at the Sundance Film Festival in Utah. Ms. Messick's name had resurfaced in the recent scandal surrounding Weinstein's alleged sexual harassment of dozens of women in the industry. Her family says she had only recently overcome an episode of manic depression and struggled to handle the publicity. In a lengthy statement, her family said Jill had become collateral damage in an already horrific story. Rose McGowan claimed it was Jill Messick who arranged the meeting with Weinstein, where she was allegedly attacked. The actress also claimed Jill oversaw settlement talks which reportedly ended with Weinstein agreeing to pay McGowan $100,000, £76,000, to avoid litigation and buy peace. Jill's family refute that accusation and added, "What makes Rose's inaccurate accusations and insinuations against Jill ironic was that she was the first person who stood up on Rose's behalf and alerted her bosses to the horrific experience which Rose suffered." McGowan recently gave more details on the alleged sexual assault for the first time in her new memoir. The charmed actress claims she had believed she was to meet Weinstein for a breakfast meeting to discuss her career, but when she arrived she found out it had been moved to his hotel suite. Weinstein has denied all allegations of non-consensual sex. His spokesperson said in a statement, "Mr. Weinstein denies Ms. McGowan's allegations of non-consensual sexual contact." Mr. Weinstein has further confirmed that there were never any acts of retaliation against any women for refusing his advances. In the memoir titled Brave, obtained by the New York Times, she alleges the studio exec forced her into the bathroom in his suite and tore her clothing off. "My clothes are getting peeled off me," she writes. "I back into the wall, but there's nowhere to go." He then allegedly proceeded to perform oral sex on her while masturbating. The actress claims that Weinstein then tried to blacklist her from the industry. "It seemed like every creep in Hollywood knew about my most vulnerable and violated moment," she writes. "And I was the one who was punished for it." Subscribe to our YouTube channel.